are thrilled to be here on the first day that we are making Central Park north of 72nd Street car-free, permanently. Right.
Look at it this morning, a gorgeous morning, not a single car on the loop, lots of people enjoying some exercise and fresh air. We invite all New Yorkers to come on by here, enjoy this park the way it was meant to be, car-free.
This is what Olmsted and Vox intended, what we're looking at right here. This is the oasis, the refuge, the paradise that we've been fighting for all these years.
Well, is this an historic day? I mean, you have to imagine when these parks were designed, they were for people strolling, enjoying the outdoors, and now to return a park to car-free, people don't have to smell car exhaust, they don't have to look over their shoulder, they can now come to this beautiful oasis and just enjoy and soak in the beautiful scenery, have a stroll, moonwalk, skate, bike, without any interruption worrying about cars. So this is a great day, and we're excited for both Central Park, but also for Prospect Park as well.
Looks was the right time. Look, obviously we've had some engaged elected officials, we've had an activist community that's long wanted us to do this, but most importantly, we had a mayor who's wanted to do this since he was back on the city council. As you know, he's a lover of Prospect Park, he dated his wife there, he got married there, and this has long been a priority of his. And so, you know, we've been talking for some months about what was the next step to take, and today we took a big step. We're very excited.
Long time. Well, that took years. And I had the same experience that the DOT commissioner did. I was walking in, they said, what's going on with all the press? And people said, no cars on the parks. And you heard them say, yay!
This has been a long time coming, really a generation or more, a huge step forward today. I am so proud to be part of this progress. This is what we want a park to be. People come to parks to get away from the hustle and bustle of the city, to breathe fresh air, to be inspired by nature. And now they can do it truly for the first time, 7 days a week, all seasons, year round, north of 72nd Street.
We're about 10 blocks north of where our principal place to gather signatures was, although we were all over the Loop Drive. Once we hit 100,000 signatures, then we presented them to the mayor at City Hall. He wasn't there, but we symbolically presented them. And you know, we got more incremental improvements, more cutbacks in car access. But today is probably the biggest step and certainly the biggest symbolic step towards a car-free park.
For many years, I was biking here every morning. The real challenge became on the south side, where cars are competing with the bikes, competing with the pedestrians, competing with the horse carriages, and now the pedicabs. So it's terrific that we're getting cars out of the park for the north side of the loop. I think we have a little bit of work to do to get them out on the south side. That's where the challenge really is. So we have some good work ahead of us to get that done.